train, I'm certain, left the station just when it was due. I must have read the morning paper going into town. And having gotten through the editorial, no doubt I must have frowned. I must have made my desk around the quarter after nine. With letters to be read and heaps of papers waiting to be signed. I must have gone to lunch at 12:30 or so, the usual place, the usual bunch. And still on top of this, I'm pretty sure it must have rained the day before you came. I must have lit my 7th cigarette at 2:30. And at the time I never even noticed I was blue. I must have kept on dragging through the business of the day without really knowing anything. I hid a part of me away. At 5 I must have left. There's no exception to the rule. A matter of routine. I've done it ever since I finished school. I must have read the evening paper then. Oh yes, I'm sure my life was well within its usual frame the day before you came. Along the way to buy some Chinese food to go. I'm sure I had my dinner watching something on TV. There's not, I think, a single episode of Dallas that I didn't see. I must have gone to bed around the quarter after 10. I need a lot of sleep, so I like to be in bed by then. I must have read a while the latest one by Barbara Corden, or something in that style. It's funny, but I have no sense of living without pain. Rattling on the roof, I must have heard the sound of rain the day before you came.